house without bringing a gun. But my fame got me right, so I know I belong, yeah. Left right, left right. I'm the reason why a nigga left right, he left right.
It's legit, dude.
How you think C's got his car out the dealer, nigga?
Cause the dealer don't give a fuck.
Nah, they do, nigga. They need it. I actually couldn't take it out.
Why you say that?
You see how yours look glossy?
Yeah. Nah, mine's look more matte. Yours look glossy.
Nah, my back window.
Come on. I think it might just be where we, cause the tree. But like my black looks a little darker. But yeah, D2s, let's get those. D2 to Lauren Springs, you know the vibes. Yeah. Bad boys today. You know the vibes. So yeah, get back to you in a few. Slide it over. That's good. But come up a little bit more. Keep going. That's good. Floor. Second shot. Push it in. Right there.
Right there?
Uh-huh. Car. Next is mine. Mine's is on a slight incline, but I'd rather do it on the incline here. So we're gonna do my car next with the bigger jack stand, so it levels out more. See the 3-ton, I think those are 3.5 ton or something. Well, 6 ton, okay. Huh? But yeah, this box actually came out this SUV. This is actually his SUV. Might do a build on this. You got it?
Yeah, take it somewhere.
Got it. Take it off. It's bolt, sensor, brake line, bolt, and 3 up top. So it shouldn't be that hard. Yeah, so I gotta change my pads. Oh, look at my pads. That should look low, boy. But we got both, all the bolts out. She's taught me a trick. He said go behind the sensor for right here, because mine has more mileage than him. He probably barely has 1,000. I have over like 6,000, so.
You saw that?
What?
Once I remove the top bolt, the shit just dropped on its own.
So, yeah, so real quick. This comes out easy, the sway bar link. And like you're gonna see right now. And this is a 17, 14, and you can use a pick to get this out if you have like higher mileage. So what he's doing now is he's taking the strut, the bolts from the strut tower out, and that's gonna drop the fork, I mean drop the strut itself down. So you're gonna see it just like drop. See it just drop, boom, and just pull it out now. So all you gotta do is disconnect this harness from the strut tower itself, so you can just squeeze it and pull it out right here. Just squeeze it and pull it out. So we're gonna start on the other side. Oh, you got it. So now we're gonna compress the spring and take the top hat off. I'm gonna show you how to do that in a few. And then the box cutter we brought from Harbor Freight. And I guess if you don't know, what you do is you put the spring compressor on the strut, and you like compress it so that the shock doesn't explode when you loosen it.
And that there, boys, is how you compress this one.
That's how you do it now.
You just compress it. Like, you don't gotta worry about it being.
Nah, what's this, bro? Why is it separating like that?
Because that's the top. That piece where the grommet is at is the top piece of the thing. Remember, you're catching it from the middle, so it's separating like that.
I thought I was ripping something first.
Nah. Just remember that orientation, how it goes, though.
What do you mean?
Like, what's on top of what? Like, remember how it goes.
Oh, yeah, yeah, because I'm going to just transfer it right on.
Yeah.
I'm going to have the other spring out, put it side to side.
So it's this one. It's this one, right?
No, that's the rear. That's the rear.
Yeah,
that's that one.
This is the front. Don't put on the wheel. So this is the front.
17.
Just catch the top hat now. Point that shit that way just in case, nigga. That pry bar, let me see.
What'd you like this?
Yeah. I'll try it now. Came out.
Yeah. Not coming out.
All right, so when you're taking the strut off the thing, I remember, because like I remember doing suspension back in the day, you have to grip right here with the vice grip. I mean, I don't really like vice grips, but every once in a while they come in handy. But you have to grip right here and catch a 17 on top. This is for the 2016 to 2020 Civic SRs or Civics in general. And you have to spin that off. And remember the way it goes. So it's that's at top. That's all the way at top.
Then the bushing cover.
And then the spring. So this is the new spring right here that we're gonna put in. And we're gonna show you the reverse way of doing it now.
The new sheet is. And then this, hold on, we gotta get a picture of this, Papa.
Look at that. Oh. Out with the old and with the new. So we're gonna put it back together and then throw it on, and I'm gonna do mine's next.
So the spring is not gonna, the strut is not gonna travel as far no more, because this spring is shorter. So what you want to do is you want to cut the bun stop a little bit, so it gives the shock more travel.
That's rubber?
Yeah.
Oh, so you can cut it with
that. You can get a little box cutter or whatever it is. You can cut it right here, and that's it. And then you just put it back together.
So that's the front. So as of right now, we're done with the fronts. Like, I'm showing you how to do it. So I showed you the bolts, the top hat. I mean, the bolts for the top hats, how to disable it. Yeah, so after this, we're gonna do the rear so we could get the ball rolling, because now it's just there. Yeah, it's probably still early, but get the fronts done, because I don't want to show you the same shit twice on the same thing. But yeah, so this is the end result of the front. Yo, this shit is low. Like, see, his car is lower than mine. Like, he's tucking way lower, but this is like a decent height, because I live on a hill, so I don't really want to go too low. But yo, that shit is fire compared to the back. That's how it used to be all around. Seeing now his, if he could drop his and what, it tilted. Now, I ain't gonna lie, bro, the back from the front, like the way it sit right, oh my. So the rears is dumb easy. 17, 12, and it just drops down. That's absolutely it. And they already did that saw right there. Yeah. What?
This is the top.
So how's the why is the top more with more coils than the bottom?
I don't know, bro. But that's how it's fitting on the thing. Mm. You see how it fits so flush?
Mm. So the top has a wider opening
than
the
bottom. That's how it fits on the front too. You see how the front thing feel like that on the angle?
Mm. All right, so lowering springs installed. Me and C's did it. Both the cars. Still have one more car to do, but yeah, the cars look wonderful right now. Let me show you. See's his suspension still has to settle in, so let me get a better. His suspension still has to settle in, so he only has 1,000 miles on the car, but car looks way better now. But on the mod, oh my god, look at this. So much lower. Tires are tucking. D2 lowering springs make your car sit nice. Look at that. So much better. So by the end of this video, both the SIs are done. Shit's just low now. His shit look dumb though. From like right here. And then my shit. Oh my tummy tucking. Both got twin SIs, but you know. Third video for you guys this month. Third video for you guys this month. I'm trying to do a video a week. But yeah, like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. It wasn't really that informational. That wasn't really the goal of the video, but I just wanted to get it done and get a video up for you guys. So like, comment, and subscribe. Make sure you follow my Instagram for more updates. That's about it. Got it. Peace.